What we're looking at is a parasite called Echinostoma trivolvis. It's a scientific name for an intestinal fluke. It's a parasitic worm that infects the intestines of mammals, in this case, muskrats. These parasites live on snails that live in pond streams local in the area. So we go out, we get the snails, and we have to collect a lot of snails because not very many of them are infected. We bring all the snails that we collected, which can be hundreds at a time, back to the lab. We keep the infected ones, and the uninfected snails we take back wherever we found them and return them, because we don't really want to disrupt the ecology. What we're hoping to do is use this parasite as a model species to study how flukes get transmitted from one host to another. And the reason why we can use a muskrat parasite to study a human disease or an agricultural disease is because all flukes, by definition, have to infect a snail first. So they infect a snail first and then they go on and infect other things. We can't really see what a parasite does inside of its host. So what we're trying to do is make an artificial host. I've made something that's never been made in the world before. I've made snail jello. So that's just collagen extracted from snails. What I'm trying to do is see if collagen or gelatin will attract these parasites, trick it into thinking that this lump of gelatin is actually a snail. And so it will burrow into that lump of gelatin and we can see what it's doing as it's entering. I'm trying to trick this parasite into living its entire life cycle without a host. It's ambitious, especially because it's only been done once with any other fluke. But I've got a few leads that I'm following and I've got the support of the faculty, so we'll see. I'm hoping that before I leave, before I graduate, that I'll be able to make an actual scientific contribution.